this is my video from Steve's video 3. And oh my goodness, this one was so good for me. The last one really made me kind of compartmentalize the things that I do. You know, I have my things that I do that are bringing in traffic, like social media and, you know, Facebook ads and things like that. The middle part is the challenge that is really has gotten to the point of being orchestrated pretty beautifully. And then on the backside is, you know, building my Prove It business. And I know that what I need to be working on is the front side with social media and the backside with, you know, building up my Prove It business. So that gives me a lot of clarity of what I need to be working on. But today really just opened my mind, and I've been thinking quite a bit since I watched the video, like, what is it that I really would love to just do? And social media, I like it well enough, but I definitely don't love it. When I do it, it feels kind of like a to-do list. And I think, oh, I need to do a story. I need to write this up. Like, it's not, it's not a passion for me, unfortunately. I wish it were. And on the backside, I love talking to each one of you. I mean, having conversations was my first thought. Like, I just love connecting with people. But that can also sometimes, to be honest, become kind of a to-do. For example, right now, I'm making this video, but I have 19 messages that I need to get back to. And so sometimes that can feel like a to-do. So, because most of the time when I open a message, I know that there's going to be some follow-up, something that I need to do. So it just kind of feels like it sometimes can add to my to-do list, even though I love the piece of just connecting with each one of you, because I do love you so much. So that was my first thought, was I just want to talk to more people. But then when I started thinking about that, I thought that kind of goes toward a to-do list and something that it is the backside and helping with the average lifetime value for people. That in my mind is a direct result of what I invest in people. So my follow-up and making sure that people on the dream team are okay. Like, that's a huge part of what I do that I love. But it doesn't create that vibrancy in me that I would consider a pet project. Like, that's just a huge part of what I do. So then I started thinking a little bit deeper, and I thought, what is the thing that whenever I think about doing it, I wish that I just had tons of time to sit and do it. And that is, I really want to write our story. I don't know that I'm ready to commit to writing a book, but I really do enjoy the process of journaling where we have come from and where we are going, and just what we have learned along the way. There's just so much power in that. And so when we were moving recently, I have so many notebooks where I have written down my takeaways and my ideas, and I have so many thoughts for things that I want to share and content that I want to create. Like, I'm just always thinking of ideas of things that I want to share and make videos on and write up. And so that to me, feels like that could be my pet project. So I'm still processing it, because I definitely need to not be a squirrel and not like run off and try to start writing a book right now. That's not a good idea. But just taking everything that I've written and all of my notebooks and organizing them and getting some organization to my content that I have been creating. I mean, it's a mess, as you can imagine, with the way that my mind works. It is, like, I have some things in my notes, some things I've emailed myself. I send myself messengered messages. I have some things in, like, 15 different notebooks. Because I just write down things or speak them to myself as I think of them. But to organize all of that in one place, I can see the power of that. But it's something that I never prioritize the time for. I just keep writing them down so I don't lose them. So I know I always eventually want to compile them. So I've also loved the part that he shared about time blocking, that is something I'm very passionate about. So in thinking of what my average work week looks like, for time blocking, I feel like I could do 2 days a week, set aside 2 hours. And then I try really hard not to work on Sundays as much. I'm a bit of a workaholic. But I feel like on the weekends I could also grab the other 4 hours. So I think I will do mine in three sets of, so twice during the week, do 2 hours, and then on the weekends do 4 hours, to sit and start compiling my content, which I think might get me excited about social media if I just had content ready, versus thinking, oh, I need to do a story. Oh shoot, I need to do a post today, which is kind of what I do. So that is my pet project. I'm sorry this is so long. I have hours of drive time today, so I'm just knocking this out while I'm driving. Anyway, thank you for listening. I can't wait to hear your alls.